A mile is a unit of distance equivalent to 5,280 feet or 1,760 yards. Athletes have spent their lives chasing after record times at that distance, constantly reaching for new heights on the track. One of the earliest runners to popularize the sport and establish long-standing marks was Briton Walter George. He ran a mile in 4 minutes, 12 and 3 quarters seconds in 1886 that stood for almost 30 years. But one of his races as an amateur served as a red flag for the medical world for much longer. In November of 1882, George took on America's top miler, Lon Myers, in a series of 3 races in New York City. Myers bested George in the 880-yard run, while George easily beat Myers in the mile. Then came the three-quarter mile showdown.
When they finished their three-quarter mile race, they both collapsed and passed out. So they both went into what they termed comas. Walter George for about 20 minutes, and then his competitor for about 2 hours. And so the thought that the human body couldn't do this, run at that pace for a full mile, was born at that time.
Medical journals worldwide began warning that pursuit of a sub-4-minute mile was downright impossible, even deadly.
Your heart rate picks up, your breathing picks up, your body's trying to accommodate to this sudden demand for more oxygen in the muscles, in your cells. Your muscles are saying, we need more oxygen. Your lungs and your heart will try to accommodate as best they can to their maximum limit. But there is a limit to what the body can do.
Enter British runner Roger Bannister, a medical student who, due to his busy schedule, focused mostly on interval training, usually running for just a half hour a day. After finishing fourth in the 1952 Olympics and almost retiring, he instead used his failure to establish a new goal, to become the first man to run a mile in under 4 minutes, a feat he accomplished on May 6, 1954.
With 250 yards to go, 25-year-old Bannister took the lead with an amazing burst of speed. He went on to achieve the world record of a mile in under 4 minutes, sought after by athletes for over 40 years. His time was 3 minutes, 59.4 seconds.
It was a record that stood for only 46 days, broken by Bannister's rival, Australian John Landy, in Finland. That set up an epic showdown on August 7, 1954. In front of huge crowds at the Commonwealth Games in Vancouver, British Columbia, Bannister and Landy, the only two men to have broken the 4-minute mile barrier, competed against each other for the first time in a race dubbed the Miracle Mile.
Pulse-tingling drama unfolded on the final turn, where Bannister overtook Landy and drove on to victory with one last reserve of incredible stamina and will. Both men broke 4 minutes. Sports history was made.
This key moment during the race, of Landy looking over his left shoulder while Bannister sprinted past him on the right, became a lasting image, frozen in time. Bannister won the race, beating Landy by 0.8 seconds with a time of 3:58.8, but Landy still owned the fastest mile of the year, 3:58, set in June. Bannister was named Sports Illustrated's first Sportsman of the Year for his efforts in 1954, a year that ended with his retirement and pursuit of a career in neurology. Hundreds of Americans have broken the 4-minute mile mark since, but Bannister's remarkable breakthrough stands the test of time as one of sport's greatest moments, achieving what was once thought impossible and redefining the limits of what the human body can accomplish.